Hello, YouTubers. Today we're going to find out what is the best air filters you can buy for your furnace or air conditioner. So, as you can see, there's many different types, and here's three basic ones. This is a pleated. I don't know if you noticed, but it's accordion type. And by being an accordion, there's actually more surface area to collect the dirt. This is the cheapest of all of them, and it's just basically a flat filter that has some fiberglass in it, and there's much less surface area than this, so obviously this one won't last as long as this one. And then you have a third type here, which is basically aluminum screen, multiple ones put together that you actually take out and wash them. But the problem with that is it gets dirty, it gets gunky, and it doesn't screen it as well as the other two on the right. So with these three filters, there's actually Merv ratings, and basically what that is the little teeny particles that can flow through them. The higher the Merv rating, the smaller the particles it take out. So if you got dust, pollen, blah blah blah, that it'd be more comfortable, obviously, with the less pollen. But each and every one of these has an effect because the actual airflow that flows through these is going to be less the higher the Merv rating, which can cause your furnace to cycle on the high limit or even freeze up the coil on the air conditioning mode. So the goal here is to figure out which filter is best for your unit. And now you can call a heating and cooling contractor to speed up or lower the fan and how much air that goes into the house. But let's say that you don't want to spend the money and you just want to put a filter in to get the most money out of your unit. Basically, what you're going to do is you're going to start off with, say, a regular filter, and you're going to run your furnace. And as you're going to see, the fan limit switch is going to get warmer. And as it gets warmer, I'll show you where to find that if it doesn't trip off on the high limit, obviously it's good enough. So then we can step up to a higher MERV rating filter. And at that point, if it still doesn't trip off on the high limit, then this would be a good filter to do it because it's not overheating your furnace. So the higher you go in the MERV rating, the less airflow, the hotter your furnace is going to run, and it actually could trip out the, well, it, the furnace will continue to run, but it trips out on the gas valve from getting too hot in the furnace. So it causes it to cycle on and off and on and off, and that's where you lose your efficiency. So basically how you do that is you start with this filter, see where your fan limit switch goes, and then you go to your second filter, and then you see at that point if you want to go with the higher MERV rating, you can. So we're going to start off, and I know on this for heating season, this is the best one. If I go to this one, it'll trip out on the high limit, and I'll show you. All these furnaces have these limit switches that turn the fan on and off, and here's the dial that you can actually watch and see if it's too hot, to where it's going to trip out. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and start up this furnace. So I started this furnace up, and basically the gas valve kicked on, and it's going to start warm up, and you're going to see this dial start to twist and turn and warm up. So right now I have the pleated filter in, and it's actually too high of a MERV rating for this furnace. I actually should be running this one, but I'm going to show you what's going to happen by putting the higher MERV rating in this furnace, and it causes it to overheat. So now that the furnace is running, gas valve turn opened up, blower's going to kick on here shortly, you're going to see that this dial is actually turning. And as it comes along, the high limit's way up here. And as the furnace warms up, it turns the fan on. And as we keep going along, because the airflow is not enough, this thing's gonna keep heating up until it says, "Hey, I'm getting too hot. I'm gonna shut the gas valve off right here." And obviously, this is not the right filter. So the only thing you can do is say, "Well, if I want cleaner air, I gotta go talk to my furnace man and speed up the blower if it's possible in the unit you have." But in this case, it's the highest speed. This is the best I can do. And obviously, this is the wrong filter for this unit. So the house is warming up, the fan is running, and you're going to see this dial going to continue to turn,
and it's obviously the wrong one for this house. So, as you can see, this dial keeps turning. It's getting warmer and warmer and warmer. There's obviously not enough airflow going across, so with the higher Merv rating in this furnace, it's not working out. Eventually, it's going to cause this guy to trip out. So, as you can see, it is still getting warmer and warmer and warmer, and it is just too much for this unit. So, I'm going to go ahead and shut this off and switch out the filter, and then I'm going to show you on the air conditioning mode. So, obviously, this one's running too hot, 190, 200 degrees, way too much.
Now that I'm in air conditioning mode, I want to find out which one's the best. And if I put in a regular flat filter like this, it's going to have a lot more air because it has a lower MERV rating. And if I put a pleated one in here, it's going to slow the air on. So when the air goes up through the coil of the furnace for the A coil, which is above the furnace here, what's going to happen is it's going to slow it down enough to remove the humidity, and the house is going to be more comfortable. It's not going to be a damp cold. It's going to be a dry cold. So I'm going to go ahead and slide that in and fire this thing up. So our goal here is to find out what is the temperature difference across this coil, and if we have too small of difference, the air is going across way too fast and it's not dropping out the humidity. We want it right at the right temperature to take out the amount of humidity, because the humidity has to come out first before the air in your house gets cooler. So if we can optimize it and get the right amount, the best thing we can do is start with what's the best filter. In order to change this, you got to call a furnace guy, change the blower setting to speed up the air or slow it down, unless you've got a real high efficiency furnace that actually monitors this. But in all reality, most people have something like this. So what I have right now is the air conditioning's on, and what's coming in to the furnace is 68 degrees. I'm looking for 15, 17, 18 degree differential top. So now that I have 68 going in, I'm gonna check out the closest amount going out. And the best place to find it is right after the furnace here. But I'm gonna grab it at the first vent and go from there and then take my difference. So, but the closer the better. Right here, we'll call it 68 degrees. So here's the first vent coming out from the furnace, and I'm looking for more than a 15 but less than a 20 degree temperature difference. And once you get high 17, 18, 19, you're getting closer to freezing up the coil, and eventually it'll block the flow coming across because the air conditioner is getting too cold. But right now I have a real dry air coming across this. So one thing to remember is this is not going to happen in seconds. This has to run for maybe 10 or 15 minutes to get an accurate temperature reading. So as you can see, the temperature is slowly falling, and then I'm going to get an actual on this. So we're going to give it a couple more minutes here, and then I'll give you my temperature difference on this house.
Are you comfortable? You feel comfortable? You got your hair cut. You got your hair did.
So now that I let this run for about 5 to 10 minutes, my differential was going in at 68 degrees, and now my differential coming out is 51. So I'm at a 17 degree differential. So this is pushing the envelope, but as long as I replace the filters every month, month and a half, 2 months in the middle of the cooling season, I can actually keep the temperature higher because the humidity has dropped out. My cat keeps getting in here. So I already know my reading is 51 degrees. It's about 17 to 18 degree differential, which is really at the limits. And this house is very comfortable with the temperature difference, and I can actually leave it at 76, 78 because there's no humidity, and the goal is to get the humidity out.
And that's where the comfort comes in. I mean, you could have it cooler, but who wants a wet house at 70 that doesn't feel comfortable, or a very dry house at 76, 77, 78 degrees? You're much better with a drier home. So I hope I'm getting the point across. In the winter time, you want to choose the right Merv rating for your furnace filter so you're not overheating it. The higher the better, the more particles you take out, but you're slowing the airflow across your furnace. And if you slow it down too much, you can overheat your furnace, and then you start wasting money because it's clicking on, clicking off, clicking on, clicking off. In the summertime, the issue is if the airflow is too slow across it, the coil freezes. You can cause damage. And that's the problem with people that don't change out their air filters. But the whole idea is, if you know your numbers and you know you're going to change it regularly, that you could actually make your house feel very comfortable with the 15, 17, 18 degree differential tops, and get raise the temperature of your home on your thermostat and feel comfortable at 76 to 78, where before at 70 you felt miserable. And the temperature difference is huge because you're trying to beat the sunlight that's beating on your house. So any questions, please contact me. I hope that everybody likes the videos, and please subscribe. I appreciate you watching this. Thank you.